I'm Hillary Clinton, and I approve this unfair and deceptive message.
This election is about change, but it's also about something else. Experience.
It's 3 a.m. Across our country, kids are sound asleep. But somewhere in the nation's capital, a phone is ringing. Your vote will decide who answers that call.
Hello?
Senator Clinton, I have President Obama on the line.
I'll take it.
Hillary, I'm sorry to call this late again, but I need your help.
Mr. President, what can I do?
The CIA just confirmed that Iran has completed a nuclear device. It looks like the Russians, the North Koreans, and Hugo Chavez have been helping them.
I was afraid of that. When did this start?
Apparently, the day I was sworn in. Those mother those I trusted them. I gave them my complete, total trust. And they lied to me.
Mr. President.
Oh my God. I am so What do I do, Hillary? What do I do?
Mr. President, you can start by getting a hold of yourself.
I can't. Don't you see that I'm in a panic? A blind, unreasoning, inexperienced panic?
For God's sake, Mr. President, man up. Calm down and listen.
Okay.
First of all, go to our key allies, the British, the Germans, the French, and show them our intelligence.
Hold on, I'm trying to write this down.
Germans, French, show intelligence.
Uh-huh, go on.
The Russians will back down. Helping Iran is a clear violation of the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty.
The what treaty?
Ask the Secretary of State, he can explain it.
Al Sharpton? Well, between you, me, and the lamp, not my best appointment.
Well, what's done is done.
Right. Chalk it up to inexperience.
By the way, Mr. President, you sound a little stressed.
You're not smoking again, are you?
No, I'm not smoking.
You better not be.
Well, I'm not. Anyway, thanks again. And I do apologize for calling so often.
I don't mind, Mr. President. It's for the good of the country. Although, if this is going to be a regular thing, I feel as though I should get paid or something, because it's like, you know, every night.
I understand.
Is that it?
One other thing. I think the heat may be off in the White House.
Really? Completely off?
I think so. It's freezing in here. What do I do?
All right. Go down to the basement, open the panel in front of the furnace.
Hold on, let me get my pen.
Open the panel on the furnace.
Uh-huh.
You'll see a red button. Hit that once and wait about 45 seconds. It should come back on.
Once again, I am amazed by the range and depth of your experience. I would gladly trade all of my superficial charm and rock star appeal for even a part of it.
I appreciate that, Mr. President.
Because this job is hard. I had no idea. I mean, it is a ball buster.
Mr. President, would you kindly avoid the profanity? It's really one of your least attractive traits that the public doesn't know about.
Sorry. Hey, before I go, is Bill there?
It's 3 a.m. What do you think?
Of course.
All right. Call those allies.
Yeah, I will. Goodbye.
What you've just seen is a dramatization of a frightening future. A dramatization based on facts. Well, not facts. More what we call specious campaign talking points. Also, for legal reasons, I should point out there is absolutely no evidence that Senator Obama has ever used profanity, that he has started smoking again, or that he knows any less about home heating than I do. Still, the point is, the future we've described doesn't have to be. If you want a different future, a safe, competent, more experienced future, there is something you can do. You can call or write the offices of the Democratic National Committee and tell them, wait, we've changed our minds. With enough pressure, we can convince party leaders that nominating my opponent would be a huge mistake. So whether you're a lifelong Democrat concerned about our party's chances in November, or a Republican with your own agenda posing as a Democrat, since, as far as we can tell, they have no way of checking, we need you to get to the phone. It's not too late. We can turn this around. Yes, we can. I actually used that first. It's true. I did. And one more thing. Live from New York, it's Saturday!